The parasha of this week, Hashem said to Paro, Hashem said to Moshe, Bo el Paro, go to Paro. Seder? So, the question is, why Hashem used the word Bo, come to Paro? Why Hashem will not say, Lech el Paro, go to Paro? Why Bo, come? You understand? There is a difference when you say come and go. Maybe there is not big difference, but for the Torah, there is a difference. Like when Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Lech, go. The answer is, the Zohar Kadosh said, that Moshe Rabbeinu, he was worried, he was afraid to go to Paro. You know why? Because Paro, he was a big klipa, big tum'a. And Moshe Rabbeinu, he was a big tzaddik. Moshe Rabbeinu, he was a little bit worried that Paro always changed his mind. One day, Paro said, Hashem is the tzaddik, and I am the Rasha. One day Paro said, Moshe, that's it. I want to do Teshuvah. Always he was changing his mind. One day he's a Tzaddik, one day he's a Rasha. And Moshe Rabbeinu Alav HaShalom, to go every time to Paro, it was very dangerous for him. Because, you know, there is a Zohar who said, a tzaddik is not allowed to see the Rasha. Because when you see a tzaddik see the face of a Rasha, he may get influence from his face. So the tzaddikim, they don't like to see the face of a Rasha. And especially the face of somebody that ignored Hashem. That one day he knows Hashem, and then he changed his mind. So Moshe Rabbeinu was worried. So Hashem, he said to Moshe, Bo el Paro. What that mean, Bo? Bo, Ani Ve'ata. Ani Ve'ata. We go together. I will be with you. I will protect you. You will not worry from the bad influence of Paro, because I will be with you. And this is the reason why the Torah said, Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Bo El Paro. And if you see Bo, it's Bet Aleph. Bet Aleph, it's the Gematria of free. Bet it's two, Aleph it's one. That means that Hashem said to Moshe, Bo, let's go, let's come. I mean, for Hashem there is nowhere to go, only come. Hashem said to Moshe, I come with you. Bo el Paro. Not only me, we will take with us Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov. Bo, it's Bet, two, Aleph it's one, it's all together, Bo and Aleph it's three. And who is the free avot that we have? It's Abraham, it's Yaakov. And beside this, Bo, Bet Aleph. If you put together Bet Aleph, it's Av. Ab. Ab is father. Is the avot HaKadoshim, our fathers, which are Abraham, it's Yaakov. That's what Hashem is saying to Moshe Rabbeinu, Bo El Paro, come to Paro. You will not be alone. I will be with you. And beside this, Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov, they be with us. Because I promised to Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov that I will deliver their children. So don't worry from the bad influence of Paro, because I will be with you. Now, my friend, what? But this is not enough. There is something that I was explaining this morning. I did not sleep very, very, very well this night. Because I wait all year for those parashiyot. Be'emet, the best story that I have, that I like to listen and I like to study, it's the parasha of Shemot, Va'era, Bo, Beshalah, and Yitro. Those five parashiyot, I love them, because the Jewish people, we talk about how the Jewish people were born. You born in Canada, are born in Morocco. There is people who are born in France, but our origin of all of us, it was Egypt. It was Egypt. So where our origin was in Egypt. It's in Egypt that we became a nation, not in Eretz Israel. We became a nation in Egypt. Egypt was the worst place of all place. And there we became a nation. That is a message for all Jews, wherever they are. Wherever they are, they can build themselves to be good Jew if they want. Wherever they are, they can be in Canada, they can be in America, they can be in Dubai, they can be in Morocco, in Tunisia, in Russia, they can be in China, in Japan, they can be in Africa. Wherever they are, there is Hashem. Wherever they are, there is. They can build themselves as a nation. And that's why where we were born. And from there, we received the Torah. Where we received the Torah? And the worst place of all place, the desert. That means, if in the desert you can receive the Torah, so of sure, and of course, if there is a city, that it could be easy for you to study Torah. If in the desert we can study Torah and receive Torah and live with Emunah, with Hashem, so of course, wherever we are, there is Torah. This is something that Hashem, He wanted to teach us. But there is something that I wanted to tell you. That Bo El Paro, Hashem, He said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, you have to know one thing, that wherever there is Jews, I am with them. Wherever there is Jews, there is the Zichut of Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov. The Baal Shem Tov explained, as I told you one day, this: never a Jew is alone. Always a Jew, he is with him. There is with him somebody. Never, never is alone. Always, wherever you are, there is Hashem. And this is Bo El Paro, come to Paro. Wherever you go, Paro is the worst person that the Jewish people had in all their existence in Egypt. And Hashem, He said to Moshe, Moshe, this man, up to now, he showed that he was God. He showed that he was the strongest. He showed that he was the biggest. Now, together, you and me, Hashem, He said to Moshe, we will destroy him. And as a message for all generations, that's what it will be. Whoever stand up against the Jews, I will be standing against that person. But there is somewhere else that I want to tell you. You know, God, that the Neshama, you understand me? The Neshama, when a Neshama wants to come to this world, she is so good up there, she don't want to come here. And she said to Hashem, Ribono Shel Olam, I don't want to come. I don't want to go there. I have nothing to do there. I'm good here. And there is Yitzhara. There is bad people. I prefer to stay here with you in Olam Haba. And Hashem said to the Neshama, Neshama, my daughter, Neshama, Biti, here you cannot advance. Here, it's like a prince. A prince that he lives in a palace. He need nothing. And to be a mensch, to be a person, so his father sent him away to live outside the palace, to build himself outside the palace. So after, he can come back to the palace. But if all the time we stay in the palace, he will be spoiled. And if he is spoiled, he cannot be a good king. He cannot understand poor people. Because he was living always in a high society, in the palace. So he cannot. Usually, always you see all presidents and kings, they send their children out of the palace to build himself out of the palace. Hashem, he talked to the neshama. Here is nothing. You cannot build yourself here. Na'olam haban, Gan Eden. You have to go down there, the earth where there is Yitzhara, and there you will build up yourself. Then you come back to Olam Haba. So the neshama said to Hashem, but Hashem, it's hard for me. So Hashem said to neshama, don't worry, I'll come with you. I will go with you. I will be with you there. And beside this, there is the Torah. I give you the Torah, and through the Torah, you will build yourself. And I was thinking, this is what the Pasuk of Bo El Paro mentioned. Hashem is said to the Neshama. Vedaber Hashem El Moshe. Moshe is the Neshama. The Neshama, she don't want to come to this world. And Hashem is said to the Neshama, hey, Neshama, Bo El Paro, go down there. This world, we come by this world like Mitzrayim. We come by this world like Paro, which is the Satan. Hashem is saying, talk to Neshama. Neshama, don't think that it's easy to come down there and you can build yourself easily. Without the Torah, you will be destroyed. Because even that I am with you, and even that I will be with you when you receive to be a good Jew, and you will fight and beat the Yetzirah. The Tzara, he will never give up. He will come back again to you. This is a fight. It's a life fight. It's a fight night. We compare this world as the night. You know, the night. Can you imagine if you fight in the night some animals? They can see you because they see in the dark, but you cannot see them. But it's a fight. We compare this world as the night. It's a fight night. You fight with the animals. With the Satan, the Tzara. But there is something. It's Hashem. Hashem is with us. So that's what Hashem is saying to Neshama. Bo, Baruch Ata Bevoecha, Baruch Ata Betzetecha. Moshe Rabbeinu, he said to the Jews before he died, the same way that you came to this world without Averot, without sin, so I wish you that you, when you die, after 120 years, you go back to the other world without Averot. Baruch Ata. You should be blessed when you come to this world without Averot, and you should be blessed, Baruch Ata Betzetecha, you should be blessed when you go up there without Averot. So this is, my friend, what Hashem, we explain this Pasuk in two ways. In the first way, it's Moshe with Paro, to meet Paro, that he has nothing to worry, that Hashem will be with him, with the Zichut of Abraham, Isaac, Yaakov. And the other way how I explain this pasuk is about the neshama. That when the neshama wants to come to this world, she's afraid to come until she has the promise from Hashem that she will be protected with the zechut of Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov, and Hashem. And when you feel that the Satan is stronger, should know that always he will be the stronger. Why? Because if you beat him, and he is weak, so you may lose. My friend, hello? Did you understand the two ways I explained? What question you have? When a man feels, that's what the Torah said, Hashem said, he talked to the Neshama. Neshama, when you beat the Satan, you will see that the Satan, he will come back again with new weapon. You know, when there is a war between two nations, they change the weapon. Because, maybe, you know, they try to come to fight again with new weapon. But the Torah, it's always a new weapon. The more you study Torah, the more you have emuna, so the more you renew your weapon. You will beat the Satan. This is otherwise. If you beat the Satan, and that's it, so we not study Torah. So the Satan will come back to you. So Hashem, he don't give you a choice. He said, look, I warn you. If you stop studying, he will come back to you. So don't stop. Be connected. Tfilot. tzedakah, ma'atzim tovim, and this is the fight. This is the fight. You know, my friend, there is something that you have to know. You know, the pasuk said, ve'ele shemot ben Israel haba'im Yitzrayim ha'et Yaakov. This is the names of the Jews, the sons of Israel that they came to Egypt with Yaakov. The question is, why the Torah repeat et Yaakov, that they came with Yaakov? We know that they came with Yaakov. The answer is that the Bnei Israel, when they came to Egypt, if it was not the zichut of the Torah, they will be destroyed, they will be assimilated. So before the Jews came to Egypt, first they bring with them mitzvot. They came with Torah. They came with their weapon. Et Yaakov, the Torah. Yaakov, Kol Kol Yaakov. This is the voice of Yaakov. When a Jew talks Torah, when a Jew speaks Torah, that means Hakol Kol Yaakov, the voice of the Torah. The voice of the Torah. You know, my friend, when a Jew comes to this world from the other world, you know this world, it's Olam HaSheker. This world, it's a world of Sheker. You know what it is, Sheker? Sheker, it's lie. It's lie. Everything, you know, look, you eat. You eat. You make money. You make a business. Would you take this with you after your death? No. Everything remained here. So, what you take with you? Just imagine, you arrive to the other world. They ask you, hey, Mr. Yaakov, yes, well, what you've done there? Well, what I've done there, build up big business, and Baruch Hashem, I had a lot of success, I have 2,000 employees, and I made a lot of money, okay? Hey, Mr. Yaakov, where is all your business? So Yaakov answered, well, all this is down there. So you know what they tell him? You're a liar. For us, only what we saw in your hand is the truth. But this is not in your hand. So you lie to us. Who can prove us that you have all this? He said, well, I have to go there. No. You are here. Prove us here. I mean, when you want to travel, you go to the border. If you don't have a passport, they will not let you in. Even if you tell them, my name is Yaakov, they will tell you, who proved that you are Yaakov? And we can only believe you if you have your passport. You have no passport, you're not allowed to enter. So up there, the same. If you don't have what you've done this world, you are not the man. So what can we bring up there? Torah. Torah, it's a real money. It's the money that you can spend it everywhere, the Torah. That's what we say, Ashrei mi shebaa lekaan v'talmud ubeyad. It's how much it's good, somebody who came to the other world. That's what you can take with you. Because other race remained here. That's why this word is Olam HaSheker. Up there, we call it Olam HaEmet, the word of truth. If in the Torah, we call the Torah true. So, Baruch Hashem, you study Torah here, you do Torah mitzvot here, after 120 years, you go up there, you take with you Torah. Torah is everywhere, here and there. But, here and there, but. God forbid, if you make only money in this world, and you don't use it to do mitzvot with it, it's a problem. But if you do, if you have business, if you did mitzvot, you support your Torah with that money that you have, so of them you can say, well, I did mitzvot with the money that I had. But if you did no mitzvot, that means in this world we have the opportunity to change the sheker to the emet. We can change the money that is sheker that we can take it with us up there to the emet, to do a good thing with it. So we win. You understand? We win. And this is the Ele Shemot, this is the names of the Jews that they came to Mitzrayim. Mitzrayim is this How can you support this world? And to resist this world only if there is Et Yaakov, if there is Torah. If there is not Torah, it's a problem. It's a problem. And do you know what it is? Yaakov. Eli Shemot Be. Abayim is Et Yaakov. Yaakov is the word. Yikvua. Yikva. Fix. The Torah that you fix in this world. If you live good in this world, you make money in this world, but you fix time to the Torah in this world, so after 120 years, when you go up there, Baruch Hashem, you have something with you. Because you change the shekel to the emet. But otherwise, so if you come to this world and you forgot the purpose why you came to this world, and only you think about business, no Torah, no tefillah, no tzedakah, it's a problem. So when you go up there, they will tell you, you've been an Olam HaSheker. So what did you bring with us here? So the only way to save yourself from the shame of the other world after 120 years, only will you come with the Torah. Ve'ele Shemot Bnei Yisrael Habaim Mitzrayim Ha'et Yaakov. This is the name of the Jews when they come to this world. Mitzrayim is this world. And the Neshama, she's worried to come to this world because she's worried to lose her title of Neshama. But Hashem will give you Et Yaakov. Hashem will give you the Torah. Through the Torah you can live in Mitzrayim that with this world very, very well. You have nothing to worry. And you should be koviyaitim la Torah, and be'ezat Hashem. And you know what the Torah said? Uvni Israel paru ve'yishlitzu ve'yibu ve'yatzmu be'od me'od v'atem melei ha'aretz otam. Otam, it's the word otam, ve'emet. Otam is the gematria emet. That means when you come to this world and you know the tachlis, the purpose when you come to this world is to serve Hashem, and to study Torah, so Israel, so you will multiply the Torah. It will be there. You do chidushim, and then you will be full of Torah. And be'ezat Hashem, after 120 years, you go up there. You are with Torah chidusha in your hand, and Hashem Shiba likan the Torah to the Talmud together. So you see, my friend, this is for me. This is the parashiyot. Are so much, so important for me. I learn from them a lot of things. I learn from them that we should be happy in this world. Of Hashem, that we live in a world full of Yitzhara, a world of like Mitzrayim, a world that Yitzhara is like vanity, that it is always a heart strong. It is not a weak, it is not weak. And Baruch Hashem, Hashem gives us weapon. He gives us Et Yaakov. He is with us, going power. Baruch Hashem, we are only Baruch Hashem full of weapon how to fight the Yitzhara. So Be'ezat Hashem, we have only things to win. So Be'ezat Hashem, that's what I learned from this parashiyot. From this parashiyot, I learned how the Jews came with nothing and they left Egypt to receive the Torah. They came with nothing, but they came with a company. He came with a company, voilà. Hashem, voilà. It's good, like I walk in the street, I have a company. Who? Hashem. Hashem is my companion. The Torah is my companion. So, wherever I am, I have a companion. I come to Egypt, I have a companion. I come to this world, I have a companion. Who's my companion? Hashem, the Torah, the Neshama. So, I explain you more or less the two parashiyot. About Hashem, we should feel well. Shabbat Shalom, Barakah, Hatzlacha, God bless you.